Through the history of art, it's always been a debate whether you could separate art from the artist. And some people have a hard time appreciating art if its creator was a bad person. I think X is a good example of this. Some consider him the voice of a generation, and others say his criminal history and past make it impossible to enjoy and consume his music. But before you could judge a person, you need to understand where they came from. XXXTentacion was born Jose Duane Ricardo Onfroy on January 23, 1998. His father named him after the Bob Marley song, So Jose. XXXTentacion was mainly raised by his grandmother due to his mother's personal problems. X has expressed in interviews that his behavioral issues as a kid was him trying to get his mother's attention.
She, raising the kid, honestly, was on her last priorities, you feel me? So what she did was she passed me from hand to hand to people that could take care of me, you know?
Uh-huh.
And, like, doing that, like, I was put in situations that weren't the best, but I get what she was doing, so I don't resent her. I would never resent my mom, but, like, my mom had it hard, I had it hard.
When X was 6 years old, he allegedly stabbed a man attempting to attack his mother and was eventually put into a youth program before living with his grandma.
Basically, he tried to put his hands on my mom type shit.
And like, you were how young?
I was like six.
Stabbed him.
And
I bit
his flesh out and like grabbed the glass shard and like poked him with it.
In 2008, when X was 10, his father was sent to jail for 9 years in Arizona after the DEA organized a sting operation. X's father was later deported to Jamaica in 2016.
That's my boy on the radio in Jamaica.
XXXTentacion's interest in music initially started after his aunt got him to begin attending school choir, and later church choir. He was soon kicked out of school choir after attacking another student, which seems to be a reoccurring theme all throughout his life. X attended Margaret Middle School, from which he was later expelled after a series of fights. He was then enrolled into Sheridan House Family Ministries by his mother for over 6 months. X began to listen to nu metal, hard rock, and rap during his time there, which led to him learning how to play the piano and guitar. X attended Piper High School until he dropped out in the 10th grade. While in juvenile detention for gun possession charges, he met Ski Mask the Slump God. X and Ski became good friends and began freestyling and talking about music in jail. After his release, him and Ski met up again to plan a string of home invasions, though X eventually bought a blue snowball microphone and began recording music instead of breaking into houses. X started his music career on SoundCloud in 2013. His first song was called News Flock.
He's showing signs of corruption that went from something to nothing. Put his hands on his mother and now he's fucking his cousin.
But he later deleted all of his early music. His first undeleted song was called Vice City, released in 2013. In the song, he talked about his decision to abandon a life of crime for music.
I seem depressed, always being bothered, nevertheless. Keeping me out of prison and putting me to the test. They ask me what is happiness, you write it on the check. Oh, you feel it on the sweat when your dick is in the breast, huh? Give me a sec, look.
X continued to release snippets of songs and slowly built up a cult following. His fan base is known for being violent and psychotic. His early music was very loud and low quality, which he said in an interview he liked the way low quality music sounded. He thought it sounded more raw. Without even realizing it, he invented the genre trap metal, which is the combination of heavy metal vocals over a hip-hop beat.
I'll try and mix multiple aspects into it, so like, I'll go from like, we call it indie sound of rock to like a very trap element, or like a trap rock element, then I'll go to like completely like some other shit, like some jazz, like smooth going shit.
Many artists like 6ix9ine, Josiah, Poya, and Zillakami took huge influence from him. X's music kept growing underground, and on December 30th, 2015, X released the original version of Look At Me. This is the song that put X on track to go mainstream. But in July 2016, X was arrested and charged with robbery and assault with a deadly weapon. X continued to work on his debut album, which had an October 31st release date. The album missed the release date and was delayed due to X being arrested in early October on charges of false imprisonment, witness tampering, and aggravated battery of his pregnant girlfriend. After his release from prison on April 18th, 2017,
I'm free,
he released three more songs on SoundCloud, then announced his first nationwide tour on April 28th. The tour was called The Revenge Tour. generated a lot of negative media coverage, including a rapper being assaulted, X being knocked out after an altercation on stage, an audience member being stabbed, X being thrown into a barricade by security, and X punching a fan.
My nose is broken right now. My shin is fucked up. My whole body's fucked up. I got thrown into a fucking barricade by my own friends. Like, nigga, I've been fucked up as fuck lately. I'm tired. I'm still doing this fucking tour because I want to make the kids happy. And I've been trying my hardest to make sure I do the right thing and make sure I follow through and make sure I don't.
He announced the cancellation of the rest of the tour due to his cousin being shot on June 24th, 2017. All these events can paint the picture of the type of life X was living at the time. X was slowly moving into the mainstream, and in 2017, he was the 10th pick for XXL's freshman list.
And I am a 2017 XXL freshman.
Which is a yearly magazine that picks 11 rappers who are most likely to go mainstream that year.
And if the world ever has an apocalypse, I will kill all of you fuckers. Fear will be plentiful, death will be bountiful, I will spare none of you peasants. Fuck your religion, your pastor, fuck kids, and got sent to a prison in PC. I seen the devil, he's in you women, you need to
stay. X released his debut mixtape, Revenge, on May 16th, 2017.
It's been hard to participate in natural instances, and due to my history, I don't know what's next for me, but keep my composure for over.
And then released his debut album, 17, on August 25th, 2017. The album debuted at number 2 on the US Billboard chart. Many were surprised how different the album sounded compared to his older music. He talked about personal struggles, depression, and the recent suicide of a girl he was close with on the song Jocelyn Flores. Jocelyn Flores became X's highest performing song since Look at Me. It was around this time that X seemed to have a personality change. He started spreading positivity and talking about trying to find forgiveness for everything he's done in his life.
I was actually going to start a movement called The Helping Hand, where you guys like record you doing good things for people and kind of spread that positive energy in hopes that it'll make some people feel good. And I just really like doing good things for people. This is my first time ever doing this, so I'll never do this, but I hope you enjoy.
17 seemed to be the start of a new era. X released the song Hope on his SoundCloud account on February 21st, 2018. He dedicated it to the victims of the Stoneman Douglas High School shooting, which had occurred in Parkland, several miles north of his childhood home.
Rest in peace to all the kids that lost their lives in the Parkland shooting. The song is dedicated to you.
Then Question Mark was released on March 16th, 2018. It debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200, becoming X's first number 1 in the country.
And the American Music Award goes to...
XXXTentacion.
Shortly following the release of Question Mark, X signed a new album deal with Empire Distribution worth $10 million. And less than 2 months later, on June 18th, 2018, that all ended.
Surveillance cameras captured the ambush of rapper XXXTentacion as he prepared to leave a Deerfield Beach motorcycle dealership last June. Then there's a confrontation and a robbery, and the men shoot and kill the talented young artist.
I think X got shot.
What? I guess I'm just making this because the information, what I just heard, is that he's passed.